It is very silly. It's so silly. And if you look at the behavior this practice was the prevalent call you fools within the primary society through which all dominant people today
I'm giving you a lot of
hint that is signaling to you
that this story is not going to be right and the core behavior is disgrace.
So when you look at the story of the behavior of critical human weeks of intelligence, does that exist?
You
dudes out there
said to me,
how subintelligent
you now be said to be subintelligent because you go through a test system which actually grades your intellect, your intellectual content, not your intelligence.
So we got to speak.
When you want to see the intelligence,
ladies and gentlemen, here we go. First of all, I want to thank you for your interest in listening to this information. It is information that you may have never heard before, or that you may have heard before, but not in such details. It is going to put things in new perspective for you. It is going to challenge the status quo, challenge the establishment. It is going to be a new manner of looking at humanity. I am Ada Akon, the philosopher. I question things. I research things. I seek reason within reason within reason. This, therefore, is going to be, first and foremost, a reasoning over that which we call life today, with an emphasis on the human race. Some of the things that will be addressed, questioned, and revealed here are going to shock you. Many will be appalled. Many will be vexed. But many more will be extremely grateful to this information and will begin to utilize this platform moving forward. I have prepared over 40 hours of explaining, of reasoning, dealing with the many ambiguous matters about humanity today. The information is already there, although I felt it as important to begin with a sort of overview as to what you're going to hear, so that you may determine whether this is for you or not. As stated, this information is of a different nature altogether. It is shown to many as what we call today racist, and I make no apology that it is. As you will learn within this information, that racism has been misappropriated to mean bigotry in our world today, in the same manner that intellect has been misappropriated to mean intelligence. I am 100% racist, in the organic sense of the term. As it stands today, no one has offered a sensible explanation of the coming to being of humanity. We've had the religious approach and the scientific approach. And many of our scholars of the dark race, unfortunately so, have embraced the scientific approach to explain the whereabout of the dark race, posing that the dark race has been at the start of every civilization, that it is the wood which is built out of the ancient edifices and monuments that we see today, etc., etc. That strategy is helpful in many ways. But to those that take this position, you simply have to ask, what happened? What happened to this black human race of people that produced those things, that behaved in that manner, that built those things? That's all you have to ask. Because in this information, you'll find that erasing a people's history as seeming to be the reason does not impede the same people to continue to exercise their intelligence and their intellectual capacity. Do you understand? And to those that take the typical religious position, and I do mean the typical religious approach, you simply have to ask, who are the aboriginals? Who are the aboriginal tribal peoples of this planet? You'll find in this information in great details that philosophy, thus reasoning, has a problem with either naively incorrect proposals, and you will be revealed the truth. That said, I now will address the dark human race of this planet. You need to know that you are a universal race of beings. You need to know that it is you who preside over this universe. You need to know that your makeup is organic to this volume that you find yourself in, called space. You need to know that your existence here on this planet is not one which is unique. You need to know that your universal family has been on this vessel and has brought you knowledge. You need to know that planets within this universal realm are led under one leadership, and that in time you will lead this very planet under one leadership, as you do everywhere else that you are within this universe. My wish in this presentation, however, is to give you a glimpse of that reality, but most importantly, to tell you who you are in fact on this vessel. And I do mean in fact. Do you hear me? Forget all the goofiness that you learned from intellectuals. You will learn in this information that intellectualism is rather the opposite of organic human intelligence, simply meaning that being an intellectual does not necessarily translate into being very intelligent. You will learn who you are, and will learn to differentiate yourself from the rest, even though it seems a differentiation can't be made at this stage. You will learn that what had to be, as far as you're still being on this planet. So this is my premise. I am Anna Akon, the philosopher. I'll be making this information available piece by piece. Do share it. Redistribute the video at will. Subscribe so you may know when I upload new information. And make that information available to any person that seeks knowledge or utilize this platform in your debates and discussions with anyone who will approach you with the current establishment. Sadly, naive proposed. Sit back and enjoy the information.
Good evening. The essential facts are these. President Kennedy was murdered in Dallas, Texas. He was shot by a sniper hiding in a building near his parade room.
This is not a message of hate. This is not a message of militant nature. This is not a message of social turbulence. It is one of truth and reason. No matter what you do, the truth shall prevail. Because truth is life. Truth is existence. Truth is intelligence. Truth is God. I am the Akon. I am the first Akon, the leader of my people. I do not hate you, nor do I pay to harm you. I do not run a terrorist organization. I simply want to elevate the status of our people. Will you then kill me for this? Kill yet another one that stands for the truth. We shall see.
By the way, I'll tell you why mankind, thus the Caucasian and all the other Semites that came to be on this vessel, had to be by means of another foreign, intelligent, or should we say intellectual being on this planet. Why it did not just come to be through a process called evolution from the rhesus monkey, from monkeys evolving, and why, even if it were not evolving, even if it were through re-intermixing, it would have taken the presence of an other being that is intelligent, or again, intellectual being there. In further explanation, I'll explain to you the notion of evolution and in how many ways it falls apart, but briefly I'll tell you that the notion of an entity, of a type, single-handedly changing into another type is simply impossible. The notion of a DNA type somehow over the course of time or by the outer influence of nature or climate or the surrounding area changing into another type is simply impossible. And that is partly why this being that will come to be could not have come to be by itself, because the main interrogation mark within this notion of evolution now, in addition to everything else that is there. But the main obstacle is this notion of new information. And anyone that studies evolution understands this, understands that it's not possible without new information. Like I said, a type of an entity, the DNA type of an entity, cannot by itself turn into another type. That is non-conducive to the configuration of this universe. It is simply impossible. Those pale scientists that are trying to make those numbers match, trying to give you all sorts of silly, nonsensical, idiotic information as an attempt to try and make those numbers match and whatever they're proposing, it simply does not match. It hasn't matched. When you go by their model, there are so many missing links, it's not even funny. And so the reality now slaps you in the face. The reality that many of you might have wanted to, you know, just get out of the way and override it for some other possibility. The notion of this thing called God, creation, if you will, is actually the reality of this humanity, of mankind at least. And so it would have taken an outer intelligent being, thus new information, to get this being to appear to evolve fictitiously. You see, it takes intelligence to understand this. A being that is not too intelligent, it's not going to understand this. It's not going to see through it. It's not going to comprehend it. And this is why a lot of the stuff you've learned, for instance, this time dilation thing, this being that tells you that light actually travels, a lot of the stuff you learn is nonsense. When I get to explaining those to you, you'll be amazed. But it would have taken new information for this being to appear to fictitiously evolve. And that new information are those entities that have been around at the time, and they are now continually remixing with those specimens to produce, to arrive at mankind, to arrive at the Caucasian. That is what took place. Left alone, it would not have been possible. Say, for instance, they started off with just a monkey. The rhesus monkey would have reproduced rhesus monkeys. You understand? Because a type does not reproduce another type. And this is why, till today, there are monkeys on this planet. There are bonobos on this planet till today. There are rhesus monkeys on this planet. And this is the question that has puzzled everyone that studies evolution, the scientists themselves. They'll try to give you some way out nonsensical stuff, telling you there was a type of monkey some 40 billion years ago, and that was the main ancestor, and then some 20 billion years ago, another type of monkey split, and then the human evolved on its own, on the other side, and the monkeys don't have nothing to do with the human no more. It is all poppycock. What you're looking at is those beings all produced by an outer intelligent being who we mix with them, and this Caucasian today is the product from a monkey reproducing with those beings. That is your fact. The rest of mankind are remixing that took place, some of them with the human, some of them within those beings, but the new information that would have been needed to make those hominids appear to evolve as those beings. So what you'll see is each one of them is going to appear to be what we might want to call more intellectual, because at the end of the tunnel, the Caucasian being that we have today is not one that is humanely intelligent. It is an intellectual being. You know, science will have you think that Australopithecus is a little bit more intelligent than the previous one, and then Homo habilis is a little bit more intelligent than Australopithecus, whatever, and the end at all, a little bit more intelligent than that's none of that. And they are more intellectual. And that occurs because of the remixing that took place. You understand that the end at all, or whatever preceded Homo habilis or whatnot, could not have produced the end at all by itself. Because an entity reproduces its own kind. And by the way, here's one thing that Spell scientists are too subintelligent to understand. And by the way, I will break this down in complete details for you further ahead, not in this presentation, but in other teachings that I do. Go through every single one of the recordings that I provide, and you will have learned a lot. This will be completely broken down for you. But I'll say briefly for now that what those scientists don't understand, just established that a type of entity does not by itself turn into another one. But to suggest that from a main entity of an ape type of some sort, do have gone ahead and produced what is the Homo sapiens, and then at the same time, peace and love. Do go through my teachings and learn. Just learn. I just wanted to emphasize the notion that by itself, the original monkey could not have produced those beings. It would have taken new information, and that new information is that missing piece that science doesn't seem to understand. That missing piece is those beings, and it is the reality of this planet. It is the reality of what you may call creation. Wow. So this is the truth. There is something, someone responsible for this humanity. It didn't come about by itself. Monkeys didn't just pop up here and started turning into people. So if you are religious, you are actually a winner on this one. But understand that when you talk in religion and you're making mention of all this God thing, that we're not talking about ghost-like forces now. We're talking about beings. As long as you understand that, so it'll pay reverence to those beings and worship them, more power to you. But they're not fluffy, ghost-like things. All right.
This is not a message of hate. This is not a message of militant nature. This is not a message of social turbulence. It is one of truth and reason. No matter what you do, the truth shall prevail. The ultimate truth that you fear is that this is a universe of a black race. One that is spiritual and lives in the truth. We made everything. We made everyone. We made the cosmos itself, including those running rampant on the face of this planet like a vagabond today. We made everything. And those of any race, of any breed, of any kind, on the face of this planet today, who side with and stand for the truth, shall leave their greed and follow me in this journey. We are the resistance.